So here we are with another CPU review from Intel this time, and it is the Cascade Lake X, the Core i9-10980XE. But at this time, you probably know how dominating AMD's Ryzen 3rd Gen Threadripper processors are. In fact, we did post that video yesterday because that was when this processor was also launched. In fact, there was an interesting story behind this. It looks like someone from Intel leaked the launch date for the Cascade Lake X processors to AMD because it was supposed to launch at 9 a.m. And what ended up happening is AMD decided to launch Threadripper on the same day at the same time. But then Intel knew that, and so they decided to launch it 9 hours earlier. So this is what the industry is in 2019. Now, when you compare the Core i9-10980XE to third gen Threadripper, which is the 3960X and the 3970X, there's just no comparison because those processors absolutely destroy this guy. And by the way, this is the box that Intel sampled us, and we had to label the processor on it just because we need to find a way to differentiate which one's which. So yeah, that's how we do things here, specifically with Intel parts. So here we are a day later covering Cascade Lake X. I think it deserves a little bit of coverage, but I think this is gonna be a fairly short video. So why don't we get into it? But first, a quick word from our sponsor.
The Lancool II enclosure by Lian Li is the $89 case to beat that packs a lot of features with user-friendly assembly and high-performance functionality in mind, like dual TG side panels with separate shroud doors for easy access to the included hard drive cage. The interior is well-equipped for cable management and EATX motherboards once you flip the cable bar, while the back section is covered with panels for best visuals. The top is also airflow-ready with multi-lane fan installation, but this front fan bracket is next level with four positions available to suit your cooling style. Check out the Lancool 2 by Lian Li down below.
Now, I'm gonna make this video really quick because there's nothing really new about Cascade Lake X because they're still based off the ancient Skylake X architecture. I mean, the processors are still using the old X29 motherboards, so at this point Intel doesn't really have anything new, and that is bad. Now, what you need to know is that all the core counts are identical to previous generation and the one before that. Yeah, but the number of PCI lanes has gone up by 4 and prices have been reduced by about 50%. By the end of this video, you'll realize that the price cuts still weren't enough though. Another thing that's happening is a super small increase in clock speeds from the 9000 series, which was possible because Intel refined their 14 nanometer plus times infinity manufacturing process. But about those clock speeds, because of the way Intel's turbo algorithms work, overall performance can't be determined by just the base and boost speeds. There are a lot of frequency points in between those which are controlled by power, temperature, and more. That means the 10980XE may struggle to outperform the 9980XE in some situations. Now, about that pricing, it still really doesn't look competitive if you're buying a new system. Plus, the $980 10980XE sits in a weird space between AMD's $750 3950X and the $1400 entry-level price of Threadripper's 3960X. And we've already seen how it underperforms against those two CPUs. One thing that's important to consider is how the incremental clock speeds could end up benefiting someone who might have purchased a 7900 series CPU back in 2017. So for instance, if you take the 7980XE, that had a base clock of 2.6 GHz and it boosts up to 4.4, but now you have the 10980XE that starts at 3 GHz base and boosts all the way up to 4.8 GHz, and it costs a lot less compared to the 7980XE. So I personally think that this could be a great drop-in upgrade for people who bought that setup back then, because that's the only good thing that's, or I guess that's the only thing that Cascade Lake X is really geared for. Now, I'm gonna go in a little bit of a rant mode here because I am absolutely frustrated with Intel's sampling strategy, because every single time when they launch a new processor, they end up sampling their highest end processor and not their lower tiers or lower SKUs below that. And the perfect example is this guy right here. The only processor we have from Cascade Lake X is the 10980XE in this ridiculous box. We really wished if we were able to give you a fresh perspective on what these processors could offer respective to their price points. Then again, they're all pretty poor value in my opinion, but you know, it's just something that we hope Intel could improvise later down the line. So with that out of the way, let's get into the benchmarks. First up, nothing has changed from our test systems and the overall setup from our last video, other than the fact that I talked about TRX 40 and 3rd-gen Threadripper. I've also updated some items like power consumption since we found some issues with HW Info's stability test load. As we go through these benchmarks, I wanted to keep this in mind. The 10980XE is almost $250 more than AMD's 3950X, but $400 less than the Threadripper 3960X. That should give you some idea about where it stands from a value standpoint. Right away, we can see the difference between the 9980XE and the 10980XE is minimal at best. But moving on from Cinebench onto more real-world testing, and from a price-to-performance ratio, it's obvious that the 3950X is just untouchable. The 3960X, on the other hand, demolishes everything where all its cores are fully loaded, but it isn't a great value if you're running Metashape or Reality Capture, since depending on the situation, those programs don't utilize all threads. Honestly, if these results show anything, it's how the 3950X is a crazy good buy if you can find one. Now, switching to a compiler, and things start to go real sideways for the 10980XE. It might edge out the 3950X, but there's no way it's worth $250 more. It then goes to lose in Handbrake transcoding and even Premiere Pro. The only convincing win here is our Adobe transcode test, which seems to really favor Intel's CPU architecture right now. I have to wonder if that's just a matter of lacking optimizations on Adobe's part. We're then quickly back to reality in Resolve, where the 10980XE does edge out the Threadripper 3960X, but it also gets beat by the cheaper 3950X, and in Autodesk Maya, yeah, it gets spanked like no one's business. Moving on to gaming, and I'll just let these run through since the 10980XE basically performs exactly the same as our 9980XE. There are different times when each won, but those were well within margin of error. More importantly, the 3950X actually wins in a bunch of cases. Yep, that's right, Intel can't even claim to have superior gaming performance anymore. It's really amazing to see how far AMD has come. Now, while this might look like any other chart, it explains a lot. It looks like the updated power consumption test proves that our 9980XE is actually quite power hungry. That actually makes me wonder if a more efficient sample would have led to it matching the 10980XE's performance in some cases. It goes to show you these CPUs are literally clones of one another. All right, so I think I'm gonna start this conclusion with something that should be obvious by now. The 10980XE's main challenge is its price point, especially in a competitive market. Intel was able to shave 50% off of the 9980XE's price point and add a little bit of performance to it, but it's just not enough. The Ryzen 9 3950X, which costs hundreds less, eats this thing for breakfast. AMD is just so dominant, guys, period. I think the biggest problem with Cascade Lake X is its platform, because Intel's high-end desktop market used to target gamers who ended up using dual GPU configurations that can take advantage of those two full X16 slots, or people who might end up using all of those processing threads. But now, things are different. Both NVIDIA and AMD are moving away from dual GPU support, so a good chunk of Intel's customers are better off buying AMD's X570 or Z390. To me, X299 doesn't even feel like a high-end motherboard anymore. It comes with a lot of compromises. You're not getting things like PCIe Gen 4, 10G Ethernet, USB 3.2 2x2. It's a dead-end motherboard. I mean, if you're building a new system right now, you should definitely stay away from X299, and more importantly, Cascade Lake X. But if you look at Cascade Lake X from another perspective, this could be an interesting drop-in upgrade solution. Say, for instance, you bought yourself a 7900X for $1,000, and right now, spending the exact same money would get you 8 physical cores and more threads, but you don't have to worry about switching ecosystems or platforms. It's simply the same motherboard because it's still using the same X299 platform. So I think that's a pretty big deal for businesses or professionals who just don't want to spend a lot of time dealing with that entire switch. But if you are thinking about building a brand new system right now, you should totally avoid X299 and Cascade Lake X, because there are just far better options in the market right now. So that's it for me, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out some relevant content over here. Subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on a new video. I'm Ibor with Hardware Canucks, signing off, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one.